Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Rare Bird Entertainment Gaming. This is Phoenix, and I'm working on a deathless run of A Legend of Zelda Link to the Past. I had done a couple trials before, rushed it a little too much, wound up dying pretty quick and early. I'll throw those videos up eventually as behind-the-scenes videos, but I want to work on getting the actual stuff done first. So I skipped over the story stuff in the beginning, kind of got a little repetitive, and originally I wanted to do it 100% deathless with my current capabilities of capturing. I'm not going to be able to do that per se. So basically what I'm going to do is after each dungeon I'm going to create a restore point. And if I die before completing another dungeon, I'll return to that restore point instead of starting completely over. Which is semi-disappointing. It's not exactly what I had wanted to do, but it just seems a little bit more practical given my current situation. So the finale episode of Johnny's run of A Link to the Past went up today, the day I'm recording this. I don't know what day I'll put this up, but might even be same day. Don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. I'm gonna try to be semi-quick about this. You know, take my time, try not to die. The whole point is no deaths. Can't use fairies other than just picking them up to heal me. I can't use them in the sense of capturing them in bottles. However, I can use potions, and I most likely will be. That wasn't good. Anyways, so castle, sewer. Then collecting a few goodies, then first dungeon. But for now, ooh, that was pretty ugly. Oh well. Okay. Almost done with the dungeon. I don't plan to do anything cheeky. If I die in the middle of a video, I'll continue the restart from there too. I'm not gonna pause and then start back up or anything like that. Just there we go. And be needing tons of rupees. Okay, we got Zelda. Now to get her to Sanctuary. Where she thinks she'll be protected. But, you know, that guy can't protect her. But oh well. Okay. Blah, blah, blah. Push it from the left. Okay. So, sewer's pretty easy. This one of these mice has a key, I'm pretty sure it's that one, yep. Okay. The mice typically have rupees, and I'm gonna need lots of rupees in order to do this. So, yep, every single one of them have rupees. I know how to pull a switch. Okay. If you pull the left one, it drops a bunch of the snakes. Officially known as ropes. But they are snakes. Story. Heart container. Okay. So we're gonna get 4 heart pieces, bug catching net, 2 bottles, magic mushroom, magic powder, and a blue potion. And then we will head towards the first dungeon, get that done, and that'll be it for video 1. So I'm gonna do these in chunks, do everything leading up to a dungeon, and do the dungeon itself per video. So hopefully it shouldn't be a too long series unless I get pretty far and have to start over. Okay. So we got 1 heart piece, we got 3 to go. Those freaking birds. We got the magic mushroom. Thank you. Oh yeah. Since then, goofing around. There's the second piece of heart. So, not only am I doing this, I'm also going to be collecting every piece of heart to make it a little bit easier on me. There's the first pot. And I will also be collecting every item. So if you want to use this as a walkthrough, feel free to do so. For those of you that can play along. Well, good stock up area. You can go back in and out and restock some items, but don't really need to. Run. Okay. Here's the second bottle. It's a magic bottle. How does one make a bottle a magic bottle? And here's where you get the bug catching net. Okay. Got another heart piece right here directly in Kakariko. Also another place I can collect a bunch of rupees. And then we'll be going and get the final heart piece. And then we'll go get the magic powder and at least one blue potion. Preferably too, I want to keep my bottles full of blue potions at all times. When I use one, get one to replace it as quick as possible. But like, so there's the third heart piece. Okay. Odds are I'll only be able to afford one potion by the time I get there. But it is what it is. Yeah, I need bombs again. Ah. So it does exist. That's a picture of Mario, by the way. Okay. I might miss the time, but routines are more important. I can come back up and redo. Nope. Good. There we go. Heart level increased. Okay, now we're gonna make our way all the way to the witch's cabin. You can stay alive. Okay. There we go. Arcturus. Ugh. Just got bodied by one. There we go. Yep, looks like I only have enough money for one potion. That's fine. Annoying, but fine. So get her the mushroom. She says come back later for something good. But all you really have to do is block away a screen and then come right back. And then you just go right into her shop. And there. You can talk to her. She'll give you a sample of the red potion. Okay. Now we're gonna head towards the Eastern Temple. Can't get rocks yet. Annoying, but. Okay. Once you talk to the old dude, but there's really no point in talking to him until after you beat the temple anyways, so I'm gonna just head towards the temple. Kinda hoping the temple is not for some reason locked. But if it is, at least the backtracking is not that much. Nope, it's not locked. Okay. So here we are, first temple. This is not a necessary area unless you're trying to run Deathless as well, because all that's up here is rupees, but I am trying to do Deathless, so need those rupees. You only have to take the right path if you want the map. I don't want the map, so I'm not going to take the right path. So these skeletons take 2 hits from your sword, or you could just throw a pot at them. I went for the easier. This is the compass. And here are arrows, which at this point in time I don't need, but I will need shortly. Kill this guy, hit the floor switch, go in here. So only one pot, which is on the far wall, contains a key, that one right there. But I pick up all the pots. To try to get it, once again, try to get as many rupees as I can. Now we're in a room where we gotta kill everything. So the best way to kill this guy is also by throwing a pot. Floor switch here. Big key. Okay. Go through there. Right back to the main central chamber area. And this is going to contain the bow. Some more skeletons are gonna hop out, but I'm gonna just dodge. Go straight up to this room. And these guys, one of them contains a key. This is another optional room right here, but it contains a bunch of rupees. Okay. Now, I'm actually going to go back and grab a fairy, not in a bottle, just to heal up those 3 hearts. And now we're going to progress. So just gotta hit the switch right there. And this one, you only have to hit the switch on the bottom. Oh, and put my buttons. My bow. But I'm gonna go ahead and kill you so you're not in my way. This one, it is the top left switch. And then here. Now this guy takes 2 arrow hits. Okay. And this is the room I had my first death in my little trial run. Because I was just goofing around. Not taking it serious. Mainly with these guys. But that did not happen this time. Okay. If I recall correctly, we're into boss territory. Yep. So this is the first boss. Each take 3 hits from the bow. Trying to even them out a bit because that last one is a little bit of a pain. There we go. And that's the first dungeon. And I believe this is the Pendant of Courage. I don't remember which pendant is which. Yep, courage. Take it to the dude you haven't even met yet. Okay. So, like I said, for simplicity, I mean, the ultimate goal is to not die at all, but for simplicity, I'm going to create a restore point after each dungeon. So there's my first one. This is the end of episode 1. I'll see you guys next time for episode 2.